What's going on guys, this is SP Architect. In this video, we are going to model this amazing looking facade in Archicad. As you can see here, this is the only one part of the building. I have modeled this for you, a sample facade. With this technique, you can model your other facades according to this. No further ado, let's get right into that. At the very first, we are going to change our unit system with working units. Click this millimeter to centimeter and click OK. To make a reference for the scale, we are going to create more study for the building. In this situation, we can click this insert below or insert above, doesn't matter, and then go to story 0. After that, we are going to use shell tool for doing this. For the structure, let's select basic, for the thickness 25, and for the home story, let's make this 0 to ground floor, and then I'll just click here and finish here. And then the third point. It doesn't matter where we click, because we are going to fix that in the elevation. For the editing shell tool, you can click endpoints and stretch like this. I'm gonna stretch this through story 4, maybe a bit further. And then I'm gonna click the start point of the shell once, and click this curve, and click this edit curve, then make a straight line like this. By doing this, it's going to start with straight line and finish like a curve. Once we've done this, we are going to go to elevation. We are going to make some reference line for this from story 1 and offset 30 cm. After that, I'm going to make a vertical line. It's going to be window axis and offset 1 meter to here. And for the other direction. For the center axis, we can change this line type. And also I'm going to copy the reference line for the story to other story. Okay, there we go. Now we are going to model our fundamental line and turn this line to a curve as before and stretch through to story 4. Like so, and we can extend more a little. Then you just take its mirror like so from the center point. Let's select this one. Then copy with 25 cm distance. Maybe we can drag this with 12.5 cm to left to take its place in the axis. And same for this. Let's select these two and take a mirror and put in a row. After that, we are going to select them all and Ctrl plus U, click OK, input 200 cm and copy through the wall. After that, we can move all of these curves to middle of the wall. We may need additional curves to achieve this. I'm gonna select all of the curves and move to middle of the wall. The purpose of doing this is I want to make the finishes precisely. Okay, moving on. Let's click the shell, right click. We are going to use this create hole in shell. And then we are going to make a hole like so. Therefore, we have modeled these reference lines. I have made a straight line, but we can turn the straight lines to curves. And also for this line. Let's create another hole for this part. Let's click this corner and finish as straight lines. Then we just click the edges and turn to curves. Alright, let's make the same for this. We are taking the same steps, so I'll just pass this fast. There we have our first openings. I'm going to copy this first opening through the wall. Once we've done that, we are going to multi-copy this opening also. We can directly click the opening, Ctrl plus U for the multi-copy, and then click the second reference line, like so, and finish. Once we've done that, we are going to create hole for this part. We are just going to click the corners, and then click the edges, and stick them to real reference. and this one, and also this one. As you can see here, we have lots of repeating jobs, but as I all know, this is the only way for doing this. Actually, you can do this with custom windows, but you cannot open your windows to shell, so you have to make a straight line, straight wall, but there will be no meaning for doing that. The feature of this building facade is making windows on the curved wall, not slanted. We are making our reference line for the windows. We will make this curve to pass from the center. I've created another reference line for doing also. After that, we are going to take this mirror. By the way, I want to get rid of this blue reference storylines. From here, elevation, shift select all of this. With this elevation settings, go to story levels, uncheck this one, click OK. There we go. We are going to pick up any curve, magic wand tool, and then offset 5 cm to inside. For the other openings, it may cause some problems in doing that. We may have to select them one by one and offset manually. For these two, and for these two. After that, we can intersect them together, and there we go. We are going to take the same step for the other openings. By the way, while we are doing that, we can do this with different way. We already have these curved reference lines. We can select them and make them mirror. As you can see, it was extended to other opening. To here, we can make it mirror again and continue like so. Alright, we have made our all necessary reference line for windows. Now we are going to make reference line for the doors. We are going to duplicate previous curves and offset inside around 25 cm and mirror, and we are gonna close this gap. Also this one. I just go to morph tool and try magic wand tool, but in this case it didn't work. Tool set. Okay, we are going to make it manually. Actually, it can read this reference line for the making, but maybe we can continue from this corner. Click this pencil, curve, click here, and make curve. Backspace again, click this corner, and curve, this corner, and curve. It was automatically fulfilled. Alright, let's make the window. Alt click this. We're gonna start from here to here. Click this corner with this curve. Click corner and make curve. Click this face. We're gonna offset this to inside. Click the corner. Back to previous menu. Offset. Hit the control once. Input 5. There we go. We can change its material, surface, it can be any material, doesn't matter. For the window, let's just select a glass material, glass blue. We are going to hit Ctrl plus Shift, click this face, and change to anthracite. There we go, let's go to 3D. And here we have our 2.5 dimension first window. Let's extrude this one, and also this frame. It will just enough to click the face and extrude. Once you've done that, select this morph and union. It's now a single object. Now we can move this to its place. Let's go to plan. Here our morph. Drag to here. Like so. We'll fix its position in the 3D. This window is in its place. But we have some problems. There are some gaps between wall and window. In order to fix that, move this 20 cm forward. After that, we are going to rotate this vertical. To do that, hit Ctrl plus E and hold click in this corner and determine a horizontal direction. Select starting corner. After that, click ending corner. If you have trouble while doing this, you can always go to section and rotate from there. Okay, moving on. Let's make our other windows. Alt click anymore and click over our reference lines. If you click blue window, it will also make blue morph as the same. Let's click this curve instead of straight line so we can make this faster. Click this corner and make the curve. Click this corner and finish. There we have our flat panel. Let's change its surface as anthracite and then offset inside 5 cm. While doing that, do not forget to hit the control once. Otherwise, you probably move the exterior edges to inside. Alright, after modeling this in the elevation, we are going to make this 3D. We are going to click the faces and click this push-pull and exterior as 5 or 4 cm distance and make the same for other faces. After extruding all of the faces, we are just going to select all of these and move to its place. While doing that, I see the blue reference line in the axis and hold the shift key so it will be locked into axis. And then we are going to put this into right place. Ctrl plus E, hold the click, click the start angle and click the finish angle. After doing that, we can change its position again to fix the gaps, maybe 10 cm to inside. Also, in order to fix this corner, let's click the corner, stitching box, click this face and click this corner. To finish, click the outside and there we have our second window. Alright guys, I have modeled all of these windows for you. The most enjoyable part is coming. We're gonna select them all. Hit the Ctrl Shift D, Ctrl plus Alt. It's going to be multi-copied. And click the bottom parts of the windows, walls, one by one. Like so. Once you've done that, hit the Escape. And just select the all of the unnecessary windows. And then we are going to delete them. For the other parts, let's just select these windows and this and copy to here. Shift click this to uncheck this one and copy. It must be unselected. Okay, anyway, let's just get rid of them. Select these two and copy to here. Like so. Let's just fix their position. And there we have our window facade. Let's go to 3D and delete this also. And here we have this amazing looking facade. If you want to place doors for this, it's very easy. You are going to model it first with the reference lines and model in the 3D with morph tool, and then you just delete the one of the windows and place your door instead of that window. Alright guys, thank you for watching. Please hit the like and subscribe. If you have any question or suggestion, leave a comment in the comment section below. If you want this project file, you can go to my Patreon page. You can also find my other project files and other advanced Archicad courses. Have a nice day!